Welcome to this video about the Vitae RDF Planner. The Vitae RDF Planner is an online professional development planning application developed specifically to help researchers using the RDF, the Vitae Researcher Development Framework. The Vitae Researcher Development Framework is a framework for planning, promoting, and supporting the personal, professional, and career development of researchers. It was developed from research, interviews, and wide consultation to map out the capabilities of successful researchers. The RDF wheel is made up of 4 domains, 12 subdomains, and 63 descriptors, setting out the wide range of capabilities for a research career. Behind the descriptors, there are up to 5 phases for each descriptor that help researchers plan their goals and development. Researchers can use these to progress their competency in each area by setting targets, undertaking activities, and building an evidence-based portfolio of their achievements. Watch this video to hear the views and experiences from Carolina Urrego, a researcher using the RDF Planner.
My name is Carolina Urrego. I come from Colombia and I'm doing my PhD in International Political Economy at King's College. My research at the moment focuses on international regimes and the emergence of the Aid for Trade Initiative, especially its effects on least developed and developing countries. I heard about the planner on my university's brochure for research development, and I found it very interesting, so I went to the website, I watched the videos, went through information, and I decided I wanted to be part of it. My view regarding professional development planning is that it's very important because nowadays we researchers face a very competitive environment, and consequently it is necessary to build different sets of skills and resources, different levels within your knowledge, your personal skills. So I think it is very important. After using the planner, my point of view has changed a little bit because I realized that there are certain issues or areas of researchers' development that I was not really aware of or that I didn't pay attention that are very important, and consequently they need to be addressed and they need to be improved. I think the planner has especially helped me to organize myself, to see which areas I need to improve, how should I improve, and especially to set targets, because you can set goals, but if you don't have evidence of those goals, then you're not really doing anything. So it's helping me to organize myself better, and I think that has had a real impact on the way I'm conducting my work. Once I started using the planner, the first thing I did was to look at the questions and establish a lens, for example, because I'm a first year PhD, so I choose the one getting started, and to see the different faces and the different questions, because that's actually my current level. I guess if somebody else is in a later stage, they can look at the other ones, but I started with that also because the title was very catchy. The lenses focus on areas such as enterprise, entrepreneurship, leadership, getting started. When I started using the planner, the first thing that got my attention were the personal and organizational elements, because then you can start moving towards the faces, answer the questions, and basically you have a self-assessment of where you're standing. Because I guess later on you can look at the impact of your research or how to engage with community. I identified the actions I needed to take forward based on the phases. They allowed you to see which areas you need to work on. For example, there was one related to literature review. Where are you standing? So I decided that I should increase the number of sources, the number of journals I was using, and select the right information for my research. One of the interesting things about the planner is that you can upload your evidence of improvements. In that case, it's also related to your self-management because, for example, I was trying to improve my literature review, so I uploaded the new sources and the most important ideas I got from those sources that will help my research. And basically, a long time, you can keep track of those evidence and you can work on them. You can upload new evidence for every single activity that you have already designed. Now I think that it will be an interesting tool to use it with my supervisor because I'm eventually sending him information or certain documents, but if we can be connected on the same platform and we set some activities and then I submit evidence that he can also see, it will be easier to communicate, and also it will be interesting if he can see which areas I'm trying to work on. It can be very useful because it allows you to bring the information, the goals, and the evidence that you uploaded somewhere else and see it in just one page. So you can make a follow-up of your progress in the last week, in the last month, or whatever the time you've been using it. When I started using the planner, I was very excited about it. So I was visiting the website very often, almost every day, 1-2 hours, because I want to see all the areas. After I realized that I have many things to do and things to work on, I start going there not so often, but in a more productive way, because I was uploading evidence or I was making a follow-up of the activities I already set. I will continue using the planner because I find it a very good organizational tool. So it doesn't matter which stage of your research you're in, it will always help you. When I started using the planner, one of my favorite things were the lenses. So I would suggest it or I would recommend it to anybody who's just starting, because that way you can locate yourself within a different area, because not everybody has the same interest, not everybody's in the same place. So it basically allows you to see what you want to see. I would recommend any other research to use the planner because it's a very valuable and good organizational tool. It can help you on different levels, both of your research, of your commitment with communities, and on the personal level.
If you wish to use the RDF planner, please check with your institution in the first instance to see if they have a subscription. Alternatively, you can take out an individual subscription by going to our website. If you're an institution and interested to know more about the RDF planner and how your institution can subscribe, please get in touch.